So let's start with the 24th example. Now what is said? Two small spheres, each having a mass 20 milligram, are suspended from a common point by two insulating strings of 40 centimeter each. The spheres are identically charged and the separation between the balls at equilibrium is 4 centimeter. Find the charge. Okay, so if you imagine it carefully, the two balls which are identically charged are initially are suspended like this at t equal to 0. So it is but obvious, initially at t equal to 0 the ball will be touching each other, but as both the balls are having like charge, so definitely they are repelling each other. So after some time the situation will become, they will repel one another and they will come to rest in an equilibrium situation like this. The length of the thread is 40 centimeter, while the separation between them is 4 centimeter. Find charge on each sphere. We need to find the charge here. Let the charges on the sphere be Q. And let us suppose we will need this angle. So let this angle be theta. I am drawing from common point. I will draw perpendicular to this. So this will be 2 centimeter, this will be 2 centimeter because it's an isosceles triangle. Now consider the equilibrium of any one of the charge. Let us suppose I am taking the equilibrium of the rightward charge. Charge present on the right side. Its weight is acting in the downward direction. The tension in the string is acting in the along the string upward direction, while the repulsive electrostatic force is acting in this direction. Again, I will resolve T into two part. If this is theta, this is also theta. So that comes out to be T cos theta, T sin theta. You can also do this by Lamy's theorem, but this is the most common method which I am using, so that everybody can understand this. Or those who know Lamy's theorem, they can go for Lamy's theorem. Now here again, I can say T sin theta is balancing the electrostatic force of attraction between the charge bodies, while T cos theta is balancing the weight of the balls. We don't require T here, that's why we are going to divide them. Divide equation 1 and equation 2. So on dividing equation 1 and 2, T will get cancelled out. T sin theta, T cos theta is equal to F upon mg. This T and T get cancelled out. What we need to find is the value of the charges. So in that case, we must put the value of force here. Sin theta upon cos theta becomes tan theta. Okay. And that is quite simple to apply. Now I can say here, tan theta is equal to k q into q q square upon separation between them r square divided by mg. What we need to find is q. So q comes out to be tan theta into mg into r square divided by k, this complete thing under root. Okay, this mg will come there, r square will come there, and k will come down. Root of r square can be written as r. Q is equal to tan theta. So we know that for this triangle, tan theta will be side opposite upon adjacent. This is 2 centimeter and this is 40. So this angle is very small. Okay, so I can nearly I can say, as the angle is very small, so tan theta can be nearly written as theta, and theta will be equal to 2 centimeter upon 40 centimeter, 2 upon 40. So that comes out to be 1 by 20. As theta is very small, there will be, this is 40, this is approximately 40, so this will become arc length radius into theta. Okay, so I will put the value now 1 by 1. So it will be in the root tan theta. The value of tan theta is 1 upon 20 into mg. This is 20 milligram, the mass of the pith ball. So as the mass is 20 milligram, so I can write 20 into 10 raised to minus 3 kilogram into value of g as 10 into r, the distance between the charges, that is 4 centimeter. and it is r square, so out of the I will take it out of the root and that will become 4 centimeter. So it will be, I'll write here, 4 into 10 raised to minus 2 meter divided by 9 into 10 to the power 9. This 20 and this 20 will get cancelled out. So I can write q is equal to under root of 10 raised to minus 3 into 10 divided by 9 into 10 to the power 9 multiplied by 4 centimeter distance. So let's see whether in the root it is a perfect square or not. So under root of, let's solve the powers of 10. So now this is 10 raised to, this is 10 raised to minus 3, minus 3. This is 10 raised to plus 1. This will go up, it becomes minus 1. So how much that comes out to be? Minus 3 plus 1 minus 2, and that becomes minus 11. Okay, because this is milligram, this is, okay, 10. So this comes out to be 10 raised to minus 11 upon 9 into 4 into 10 raised to minus 2. Okay. So Q comes out to be, that can be easily solved. I can take this as 4 into 10 raised to minus 2 and 10 raised to minus 11 divided by 9. How we are going to solve this? So I will take this as 10. So if I multiply and divide by 10, or I will adjust the power 10 in the power, so it will be 10 into 10 raised to minus 12 divided by 9. So 4 into 10 raised to minus 2, as it is, the root of 10 raised to minus 12 will be 10 raised to minus 6. And the root of this thing, 10 upon 9 will be approximately 1. The root will be approximately 1. Okay, I'm writing this as approximate to round off the answer. So that comes out to be 4 into 10 raised to minus 8 coulomb. That is the final answer on charges on the body. Thank you.